Hi, welcome everybody. In this video, you will see tips and tricks using the Degritter ultrasonic cleaning device. I've been using this fantastic device for the last 2 years and want to share some of the things I've learned while using it. For example, if you have a dirty spot on your record, which is visible, you can give it extra attention without doing anything extra. For example, the dirty spot is at the bottom of the record. Then you put in the record also with the dirty spot at the bottom. You start your washing cycles as you would normally do, and you're giving it now extra attention because the unit, when it does one rotation, depending on your washing cycle or two or several, it will always have a little bit of an overshoot. And this is the area that the ultrasonic transducers are. So when it does one rotation, it will do a little bit of an overshoot and clean your dirty spot, which is at this location, one extra time. This can be enough to have a clean record. If you have a very dirty record and you need multiple washing cycles, then there is also an option, if you're lazy at least, to do this automatically. When the unit leaves the factory, they always test it by doing multiple washing cycles. They don't do that by hand, but they program that in the software. And you can access that also. This is the auto-run feature. And what you do is you go to the info menu. You wait till you see the info. You press the play button till you see auto run. Now the unit will keep washing your record till the temperature in the ultrasonic bath is reaching the maximum level and the machine stops and starts cooling down. One thing you have to remember when you're using this, because this goes on for at least 30 minutes, maybe an hour, that you have to stop this program, otherwise it will keep doing automatic runs. So to stop it, you just stop the machine, of course. Now I have to wait till the water is draining from the unit. It's almost there. And what you will do is you go again into the info menu and do the same sequence as I did before. So they stop, go to the info menu. You can see it's still active. Press the play button. And now it's switched off. There's of course alternatives. You don't have to be exaggerating in this way that you do multiple cycles, you can also increase your cleaning solution. So when you have your Degritter standard solution supplied with the unit, you also got this pipette and you can increase the dosage. For example, you go from 2 milliliters to 3 or 4. 4 is the maximum. I usually use this syringe, which is a little bit more easier to operate, but I would say 4 is the maximum. As an alternative, you can use alcohol, because that's the great thing about this machine. You can make your own cleaning solution. It can handle almost anything. So when you go, for example, to isopropanol, you can add quite a bit. And this is especially effective when you have dirt or more oily based dirt on your record. Then again, I use a syringe. And for example, in this syringe goes to 20 milliliters. That's also about what I extra add to the cleaning solution. And that way you can effectively clean your oily spots or the dirt that is not removed with the standard cleaning solution more easily. When you're cleaning, you have a specific level and you can adjust that. So when you go into the menu of the water level, you see you have 3 different levels. In general, what the manual suggests is when you have 7-inch singles, you go to the high setting, and that is mainly because if you compare a 12-inch with a 7-inch, the dead wax on a 7-inch usually goes closer to the center of the record, and also the label is a little bit smaller. But what I have found out is that when I put it in high setting, also for the 12 inches, the cleaning is a little bit better. And I don't know if there's a technical reason, but it seems that surface dust, which rises to the surface while cleaning, and the active cleaning is active in the device, it is more effective in removing this top layer of dirt, which is floating on the water, filter it and put it back into the ultrasonic without the dirt, of course. That brings us to the filtering of the system itself. The inside, you have to keep that clean, of course, also. One of the first things you have to do in a regular basis is clean your water tank. There are different options. You can put it in the washing machine. I think that's a little bit much. I use just some soap for hand washing and use something, and don't use the abrasive side, but spongy side. And for example, clean especially the bottom part, because through settlement, the dirt will settle at the bottom of your water tank. This is the least easiest to access, but it's important that you clean it. You will see when you clean it that you will pick up dirt from that position. Through the many times I've used the machine, I also checked if the ultrasonic tank was dirty. Is there dirt assembling on the inside? Until now, I have not been able to spot any dirt inside. Usually it is at the bottom of the tank that the dirt collects. But you have to also be sure that the piping or the tubing inside the unit and the pumps are clean. To clean them, I do that, I think, every 10 times I exchange the water, I will do also clean the inside, and I do that with some vinegar. And you can get this at grocery. It's cleaning vinegar, which in Dutch is schoonmakerzijn. And what I do is, if you have your water tank, there's a marking on it for minimum and maximum, and I fill it from minimum to maximum. So I think that's around 100 milliliters of vinegar to the machine, and then I start a heavy program so that the inside of the machine sees this water. After that, of course, you have to throw it away. You cannot use it again because the vinegar, I would not clean my records with it. Maybe it's possible, I've not tried it in any way. Then you have to clean the filter. As you know, there's an active cleaning inside which uses these kind of filters. To open it, I think in Europe everybody knows you have these Euro 5 cents, which are perfect at opening the filtering system. You get these filters, you can filter them or clean them or exchange them. I think most of us clean them because they're not that cheap. I have made my own. These are my do-it-yourself cleaners or filters. I make them from this filter material, which is available for aquariums. You can see you have a very big part. This is not that expensive, it's actually cheap. With this kind of piping system, I go through the material, pull it out, and that what I get is these, and I cut them to the right size. Since using this, I find myself replacing the filter material more and more often. So that is, I think, beneficial to getting a clean water. Although cleaning it by hand is just as effective. As you can see, they're not as fine. They're a little bit more coarse as the standard material, but still effective at removing the dirt from your water. Then we have cleaned the inside. We have cleaned the record, so there are only a few tips left. For example, the drying. One topic is the drying. You can set it at different timing schedule. So you have 2 minutes, that's my standard timing, and you can increase it by steps of 15 seconds. I have the preference to, when I change the setting, to do it in steps of 30 seconds, because if you start the drying, you will see it will take one complete rotation, takes 30 seconds. So there's no real benefit to switch it to 15 seconds, because 30 seconds is one rotation, 1 minute is two rotations, four is 2 minutes, and six rotations is 3 minutes, or if you go in between, you can go five or 2.5. But as you can see, there's no 15, so I would not put it in a value like 2 minutes 15 or 4 minutes 15. I would put it or switch it in steps of 30 seconds. And one last thing is, the unit has a switch off button at the back of the unit, but you can always use the stop button. When you press that button, it will say goodbye and switch off in that way. And the next time you press play, it will say welcome and start up immediately, and you can clean your record. I hope these tips are helpful for you. Now it's time for me to say goodbye. Thank you for watching. See you next time.